Today we're going to talk about Barrandov, which is a part of Prague with a big highway bridge, beautiful old swimming pool, TV studios, but mainly a part of Prague where a TV station is based. A TV station called Barrandov that airs a show that is very interesting and somehow bizarre.
Krásný dobrý večer.
Můžete být tím, co bude tvořit svůj budoucnost.
No, kdyby tady stála opice, jak je to fuk.
As you may know, we are not only honest Prague guides that film Prague-related videos, but we are also journalists that like to uncover scams. And usually we uncover street-related scams like money scammers on the street and exchange offices. But since we spent the last year in quarantine sitting at home, we spent a lot of time in front of our TVs. And while doing that, I actually came across a scam on the TV. This show that runs behind me is called Rychlá hra, Quick Game. And the idea of the game is quite simple. You see a puzzle on the screen, you pick up your phone, you call to the studio, and if you can solve the puzzle, you can win from 4 up to hundreds and sometimes even 1,000 euros. By the way, no wonder the show is right now running behind me on the TV, because it runs 5 hours a day. Of course, if you want to get into the studio, you have to pay for the phone call, and it ain't cheap. It costs 95 crowns per phone call, which is almost 3.6 euros. Well, where's the problem, Janek? You pick up the phone, you pay something, and you get into the studio and win a lot of money. Well, not really, because the system is a bit crooked. In the beginning of the show, a lot of people get connected through and they talk in the studio.
Je to správně, Martine.
Je to správně, 300 českých korun je vaši.
A 4.
Ano, máte 300 korun.
After a couple people get through to the studio and win a couple euros, a marathon of bullshit from the hosts of the TV show will start.
Pojďte znova zavolat. 3, 2, 1, start. 2 minuty. Musíte zavolat. Ale nemáme čas zase, pojďte rychle, pojďte další.
They will beg you that you should call.
Je poslední nabídka,
poslední nabídka.
All this just for one reason, so you make the phone call.
Zkuste to, nemáte co ztratit, můžete jenom získat.
So we did make the phone call, and not just one, a couple. Because this is what we heard on the phone line when we called.
A nám se to povedlo, nevzdávejte to. Tohle může být váš šťastný den.
My lucky day.
Chce to znovu. To je fantastický. Málem se to podařilo. Zavolejte znovu.
Propásal jste šanci být ve studiu. Zavolejte znovu.
Takřka se podařilo. Zavolejte znovu teď a zkuste se stát výhercem dnešního dne.
Skoro jste to dokázal.
Zavolejte zpět a můžete se stát výhercem dnešního dne.
Hello? Oh, I'm sorry. Wrong number. Sorry. Right, I guess you get the idea. By the way, the scam is almost double proof, because if you actually make it with the phone call to the studio, sometimes the question, the quiz game, is very hard. For example, in the latest one, you had to guess a name.
Já už budu muset ukázat správnou odpověď. Hemani Raveno? Tohle byla správná odpověď.
Yep, the correct answer for a name you were supposed to guess was Hemani Ravena. It's a very common Czech name. My grandma was Hemani Ravena. My mom is Hemani. No, there's one person in the entire country that is called Hemani Ravena. It's a parent's revenge. Oh, and by the way, sometimes it's not a scam, but just a lie. When the host will say things like, everybody who will call will win 8 euros.
Každý z vás, kdo zavoláte, dostanete minimálně garantovanou částku 200 korun.
Which is a complete and utter lie. Oh, and also a violation of the Czech law. Unfortunately, many people do call the show with the hopes of winning some money. And there's a lot of proof of that online.
My grandma wasted 1900 crowns without ever making it to the studio. Robbery over the phone. My daughter won a phone bill for 7000 crowns.
Yep, the last guy actually mentioned that his daughter got him a phone bill for 270 euros. And no wonder kids call this game. It's on live TV, there's moving pictures, moving animals, and I've watched a lot of these episodes, and there's a lot of kids getting through.
Winner!
Dobrý den.
Dobrý den, kolik vám je let?
A kolik vám je let?
18.
Fakt, jo?
Jo.
Hele, hele, hele.
Speaking of the devil, the host behind me, his name is Karel, and we actually managed to have a chat with him, not through the paid lines, but through his personal phone number. And we asked him what he thinks about the show.
Práce jako každá jiná, já moderuju už od roku 93. Mým cílem je, aby ten divák ty peníze vyhrál.
In the very beginning of the show, you let a lot of people through, they get connected, they win some money, and then there's nothing for hours, nobody gets through, and at the very end, you connect just one person, and sometimes even they don't get through or get the money.
Bohužel, proč to tak je, to vám na to nedokážu dát žádnou odpověď, protože to netuším. Já jsem moderátor a mě to v uvozovkách vůbec nezajímá.
Don't you feel like this whole thing is a scam?
Podvod na ty lidi.
Je to hra, jako když půjdete, koupíte si los, všude vám píšou, že každý los vyhrává.
Karel pretty much defined this TV game as a lottery ticket. You can also buy lottery tickets and scratch them off. Well, the problem there is that lottery tickets fall under the lottery law in our country, and the laws are pretty strict. For example, you have to know the odds of winning with a lottery ticket, which we checked with a lottery game.
Tak pravděpodobnost získání výherního losu je 1:3,37.
When we wanted to know what the odds are in this game, we called their helpline to find out. Well, to not find out.
To já vám nepovím, že do studia to přepíná počítač.
Well, how's the computer set? To what odds?
To vám nikdo nepoví.
So if this show is not a lottery game, what is it then? I actually do know the answer. This, what's running behind me 5 hours a day on the Czech TV, is a TV home shopping. And what are they selling on this show, you ask? You didn't notice? It's there the whole time. This magazine called Sedmička. It's a silly tabloid magazine.
So when you make that phone call, you're not calling for the game or to win the money. You are buying a magazine. The entire show is there to promote the magazine, as they claim on their website.
Which is really great, because once you get the magazine, you can actually mark in the TV program when you're being scammed on their live TV. Also, you're not getting the paper version, you're getting an e-version for 3 months if you make the phone call. Which, by the way, means that the guy whose daughter got him the phone bill for 270 euros actually prepaid him this magazine for, I kid you not, 18 years. So we asked Karel, how does he morally feel about this?
From my point of view, you are just scamming elderly people.
Teď jste zaštval i vy mě, protože jste mě spojil s něčím, s čím já se neslučuju. Někoho úmyslně ožebračil. A už vůbec ne důchodce, protože tam jsou i mý rodiče.
He has to know what he's doing. I actually found a website where people that used to work on this TV show describe what the hosting of the show was like.
High pay is amazing. I got $3,000 for one 1.5 hour show. Dishonest way to make money by scamming people, though.
Did I just hear dishonest way to make money by scamming people? Well, that's why we're here. These jokers know very well that they're scamming people. There's actually an ex-host of this show on YouTube where after she left the show, she very specifically and in deep details described how they were scamming people on the show. This girl even describes how she or they were using emotions to get people to call, and they were using scripted situations where she would be yelled at by the director to work harder and get more people to call. Yelled at by the director?
No!
That's right, what you just heard was the screaming of the Polish director that could be overheard on the Czech TV show, because this scam is not only Czech located, it's a global thing, and it was all made in one building. This show was broadcasted in more than 40 countries around the globe. Brazil, Finland, Switzerland, Portugal, and even Czech Republic. In most countries, it's been canceled, and in some countries, it's been even banned by the law. All of it was actually created by one production company. It's a company based in Cyprus, but operating in Hungary, in Budapest, where they had this huge building with studios, and they were broadcasting to any country in the world. I'm sure that you will know this show from your country. They even broadcasted this to Belgium, where a really cool group of comedian actors called Basta managed to get one of their guys on the show to be the host, just to uncover what kind of a scam and fraud it is, and they managed to get the show canceled. We actually made this exact same video that we're doing right now here in English last week on our Czech YouTube channel to show it to the Czech audience and see what the reaction from the Czech authorities will be. And believe it or not, the Czech phone providers said that they either change the show and be more fair or they will cut off their lines. And just to be clear here, this is not a new thing. I myself have been doing a video about this 7 years ago, and we managed to get the show off the air because they were violating the law. And now they found a new loophole, calling it the TV teleshopping selling magazine bullshit. Oh, and by the way, this is super important and I have to address it. If any of the companies that we're mentioning today will decide to sue us for this video and for what we're saying here, well, this is not a video regarding scam. This is a TV commercial for our book. It's been right there the whole time. We're just selling our book here. So we're reaching out to you now because we know you are from all around the world, and I bet you that this show was running on your TV. So if you can write us the story of your country, if this show still airs or was canceled, or maybe your country has better laws than our country, I would love to find out. So if you do have something regarding TV scams on your TV in your country, please write to us at podvodky@gmail.com. It will get lost in the comments, so write to this email. I will read it and we will definitely make a follow-up episode, because already now things here in our country are starting to move in the right directions. And these jokers already know we're after them. This is what they broadcasted yesterday.
On vlastně ten chlapec z toho videa měl ty brýle. No jo, no tak silnější, hochu, silnější. Protože opravdu ten řadek vidíme všichni zřetelně tady dole, takže to byla jenom přece taková mini narážka na jednoho takového panáčka. To není pán, to je panáček.
Ah, right in the heart. Hello darkness, my old
friend. Wait, hold it. Before we continue on with the video that you're watching, and I'm actually editing right now, there's a big news that just surfaced, and I feel like I should tell you. Let me just read it to you here. Oh yeah, the show got canceled. Back to you in the studio.
Nikdo nemá ponětí, takže ukončíme. Nevíte, nechcete hrát. Nebaví vás to.
That's it. I'm Janek. There's Honza behind the camera. If you want to see that picture, you gotta check out our Instagram. We also have a Patreon. And as I mentioned, you can actually buy our book. And I'll see you next week, next Sunday, on another episode of The Honest Guide. Today's Czech lesson is brought to you by Karel. And the word is poslední šance, last chance. Poslední šance, last chance. It usually refers to a moment when you have a last chance. Like there's a minute to go. It's your last chance. There's last second to go. In this case, there are still 2 hours and 40 minutes till the end of the show. So that's not how you would use the word poslední šance.